Magandang araw, Kapamilya. Today is Wednesday of the 4th week of Easter. Our Mass presider is Father Tito Caluag. Entrance Antiphon. I will praise you, Lord, among the nations. I will tell of your name to my kin. Hallelujah.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, to prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us call to mind our sins and ask the Lord for pardon and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
And let us pray. O God, life of the faithful, glory of the humble, blessed of the just, listen kindly to the prayers of those who call on you, that they who thirst for what you generously promise may always have their fill of your plenty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The word of God continued to spread and grow. After Barnabas and Saul completed their relief mission, they returned to Jerusalem, taking with them John, who was called Mark. Now there were in the church at Antioch prophets and teachers: Barnabas, Simeon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Cyrene, Manaen, who was a close friend of Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them." Then, completing their fasting and prayer, they laid hands on them and sent them off. So they, sent forth by the Holy Spirit, went down to Seleucia, and from there sailed to Cyprus. When they arrived in Salamis, they proclaimed the word of God in the Jewish synagogues, the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. O God, let all the nations praise you.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May God have pity on us and bless us. May He let His face shine upon us. So may Your way be known upon earth, among all Your nations, Your salvation.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May the nations be glad and exult, because you rule the peoples in equity. The nations on the earth you guide.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us, and may all the ends of the earth fear him.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
Alleluia, alleluia. I am the light of the world, says the Lord. Whoever follows me will have the light of life. Alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A proclamation of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me, not only in me, but also in the one who sent me. And whoever sees me, sees the one who sent me. I came into the world as light, so that everyone who believes in me might not remain in darkness. And if anyone hears my words and does not observe them, I do not condemn him, for I did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world. Whoever rejects me and does not accept my words has something to judge him. The word that I spoke, it will condemn him on the last day, because I did not speak on my own. But the Father who sent me commanded me what to say and speak. And I know that His commandment is eternal. So what I say as the Father told me." My dear brothers and sisters, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Siguro, no, sa pagninilay natin, di ba, kung paano tayo ngayon, di ba, matapos ang eleksyon at unti-unti nagiging klaro ang mga bagong halal na pinuno natin, palagi ko mahalaga rin sa ating mga mamamayan, ano? ang patuloy na mangilatis, papaano tayo patuloy na makikilahok sa ating demokrasya. I think it's important for us to reflect on that this past campaign period, we saw so many people become more active than usual. No, let's face it, more than previous elections, you see a great amount of volunteerism from different camps. No, and I guess most especially the youth. No, we saw this when they registered in numbers. No, during the registration period for new voters, and we saw this in the many volunteer groups. No, which a lot of which were really youth volunteers. No, again, regardless of whose camp was supported. I think one cannot deny that the spirit of volunteerism became a very strong element in this campaign. And I guess it's important now how to move forward, no, for the different groups and how to collaborate and work together where work can be done together and where to become also checks and balances. Remember, let's put it this way. I read somewhere yesterday, no? Sabi nila, unity is not uniformity. No? In fact, when you take a look at the unity of the Holy Trinity, the unity that it gives us is that it allows each and every member to become the best of who they are. The Father is the Father, the Son is the Son, the Holy Spirit is the Holy Spirit, each with a particular mission, but also united in fulfilling the mission. No? So maybe just this, that one, in a sense, parang ano to, introduction sa ating pagninilay. Na mahalaga na makita natin na yung pagkakaisa ng banal na Santismo Trinidad, na sila ay nagkakaisa sa misyon, pero bawat isa ay umigting ang pagkaako, ang pagkasarili nila. No? Ang Ama ay ang Ama, ang Anak ay ang Anak, at ang Espiritu Santo ay ang Espiritu Santo. Yun yung mahalaga natin na sana ay ipanalangin. No? Siguro 3 punto lang na pagninilay natin kung paano tayo pwedeng magnilay, kung paano uunsad mula ngayon. Ano? Lalong-lalo na sa ating paglampas sa pandemyang ito. Kailangan magtulungan. But tandaan natin noong nakaraang simbang gabi, meron framework na binigay ako noong 9 na araw ng ating nobina mula sa Santo Papa. Remember the Pope said, "For us to get out of this crisis, we need to see clearly. We need to choose well, and we need to act right." Remember that after the elections, the crisis of the pandemic, and the crisis of, again, recovering from this pandemic, and to provide services, genuine and authentic services to our people, majority of whom are marginalized and underprivileged and vulnerable, mahalaga pa rin na ating kilatisin yun. Papaano tayo lalampas sa krisis ng pandemya? Na naglikha ng krisis ng ekonomiya, no? So, to see clearly, to choose well, and to act right. Sa Ebanghelyo ngayong araw, merong masasabi natin 3 tip, kumbaga. Una sa lahat, sabi ng Panginoon, kailangan maniwala kayo sa akin. At muli natin pag-ibayuhin ang ating pananampalataya sa Panginoon. That you must be, as the Lord said, that whoever believes me not only believes in me, but believes in the one who sent me. Let us renew our faith, no, after these elections. Renew in our faith in God, that God will continue to guide what happens in the events of history, that He is the Lord of history. But we must renew that faith. No? I'm sure some are disappointed, some are happy, victorious, but at the end of it all, we renew our faith in God. Ito ang isang pagmumula ng ating pagbubuklod, ang ating pananampalataya sa Diyos. Our faith in God, to believe in God, will become the source of our being brought together again as one community working to build the kingdom of God. The second point is that the Lord clearly tells this, no? Tells us this. I came into the world as light. So that everyone who believes in me might not remain in darkness. Siguro yun yung pangalawang punto ng pagninilay. Hilingin natin ang liwanag ng Panginoon. Liwanag sa ating kaisipan, liwanag sa ating mga puso, at ang liwanag na magagabay sa landas na tatahakin natin. Let us pray for that light, that the Lord may send this light to guide our minds and hearts in the path that we need to travel ahead. as one church, as one country, as one people, let us ask for the light of Christ that will overcome all darkness and evil. And this is part of the faith that we need to renew. The third and last point is that the Lord says, you must observe my words and you must act on them. Again, mahalaga na balikan natin ang salita ng Diyos, ang banal na kasulatan, at ang lahat ng mga pagpapahalaga na binibigay sa atin ng Panginoon sa banal na kasulatan. We need to go back to the Word of Christ. The Word of Christ that comes to us in Scripture, but also the Word of Christ that comes to us in the context and events of our life. Mahalaga na gabayan tayo rin ang salita ng Diyos. At sabi nga ng Panginoon, and to observe my words, maging masunurin sa salita ng Diyos. Today I ask all of us to pray that we may have a renewal of faith, that we may ask the light of the Lord to guide us and the word of the Lord to continue to deepen our sense of following of Christ. In the end, as the Lord said also, we need to make choices. Kailangan natin mamili upang maging higit tayong tapat sa hinihingi sa atin ng Panginoon sa pagkakataon nito, na ito sa ng ating bansa at ng ating simbahan. Patuloy natin ang ating misa at patuloy natin idalangin ang ating bayan at ang ating mga pinuno. God never intended us to die. He created us for life, but we chose death. Christ, our Redeemer, restores us to life, and we come to our Father praying through Him, Lord, hear our prayer.
That our Pope and bishops may continue to proclaim the good news of Christ's resurrection, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That government officials may imitate the compassion and gentleness of Jesus in caring for the least of His brethren, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That people in nations afflicted by poverty may be drawn to Jesus who became poor for our sake, we pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. And let us pray again for all the intentions commended to our prayers. For this let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And let us now offer our post-election prayer for our people and our country. God, our Father, we put our trust in your promise that you will send us leaders after your own heart and spirit. Lord Jesus, inspire all who will be our new leaders to be servant leaders who will put the greater good of the greater majority, especially the poor, the marginalized, and the vulnerable, above any personal or group interests. Servant leaders who will seek to serve genuinely, to serve and not to be served. Servant leaders of integrity and compassion. Holy Spirit, continue to enlighten our minds and hearts that we may see clearly the needs of our people and society, and hold our new leaders accountable that they may truly lead and serve. Leaders after your own heart and spirit, leaders who will unite and lead us to do what is for the greater good of the greater majority and what is for your greater glory. Father, Son, and Spirit, you are the God of life and love, the Lord of history. Be with us in this moment of transition and a new beginning. Amen. Our Lady of Fatima,
pray for us.
Our Lady of the Immaculate Conception,
pray for us.
By the mystery of this water and wine, may we come to share in the divinity of Christ, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, to your goodness. We have this bread and this wine to offer. Fruit of the earth, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands, they will become for us our spiritual food, our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever.
Pray, my dear brothers and sisters, that this our sacrifice may be made acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead. Grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times, to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For with the old order destroyed, a universe cast down is renewed, and integrity of life is restored to us in Christ. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the night that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, he gave you thanks, he broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Again, he gave you thanks and praise. He gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, this life-giving bread, this saving cup. We thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Onesto, our Bishop, the clergy, the entire people your Son has gained for you. Remember, Father Most Holy, all the intentions commended to our prayers at this Mass. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them, Lord, into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have blessed you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to pray.
Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, from every evil, and grant us peace in our day. In your mercy, keep us free from sin, and protect us from all anxiety, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "I leave you peace, my peace I give you," Lord, we beg you not to look on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace the unity and the joy of your kingdom where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
May the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
My dear brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold Him who takes away our sins, the sin of the world. Happy are we who are called to share in the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
May the body and blood of Christ bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen. My Jesus, I believe that you are present in the most holy sacrament. I love you above all things and I desire to receive you into my soul. Since I cannot at this moment receive you sacramentally, come at least spiritually into my heart. I embrace you and unite myself wholly to you. Never permit me to be separated from you. Amen.
And let us spend a few moments of silence. And together now, let us pray the Oratio Imperata.
Merciful and compassionate Father, we confess our sins and we humbly come to you to find forgiveness and life. We come to seek your protection against COVID-19 that has disturbed and claimed many lives. We ask you to look upon us with love and by your healing hand dispel the fear of sickness and death. Restore our hope and strengthen our faith. We pray that you guide the people tasked to find cures for this disease and to stem its transmission. Bless our efforts to use the medicines developed to end the pandemic in our country. We pray for our health workers, that they may minister to the sick with competence and compassion. Grant them health in mind and body, strength in their commitment, protection from the disease. We pray for those afflicted. May they be restored to health. Protect those who care for them. Grant eternal rest to those who have died. Give us the grace in these trying times to work for the good of all and to help those in need. May our concern and compassion for each other see us through this crisis and lead us to conversion and holiness. Grant all these through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We fly to your protection, O Holy Mother of God. Do not deny our petition, but deliver us always from all dangers, O glorious and ever-blessed Virgin.
Amen.
Our Lady, help of all Christians and health of the sick.
Pray for us.
Our Lady of Fatima.
Pray for us.
Saint Joseph.
Pray for us.
Saint Raphael the Archangel.
Pray for us.
Saint Roch.
Pray for us.
Saint Lorenzo Ruiz.
Pray for us.
Saint Pedro Calungsod.
Pray for us.
Most Sacred Heart of Jesus.
Have mercy on us.
Santo Niño de Cebu.
Have mercy on us.
Divine Mercy.
Have mercy on us. And let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless us, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Let us go in peace to love and to serve the Lord and one another.
Thanks be to God.
Bukas po, magsisimula ang Season 2 ng Proyekto Filipino. Magpipremiere ng 7 p.m. sa The Conscience Collective YouTube channel at papalabas din sa mga Sky Cable channels. Ano, sa, excuse me. I think simula Biyernes hanggang Lunes. So please join us because it would be a very interesting discussion. In a sense, a post-mortem of this past election. Sandaan ho natin, yung first season was to help us prepare for the elections. Ngayon naman po, magsisimula sa pagninilay sa nakarang eleksyon And then we now go into other topics for civics, history, and politics. Now, hopefully, it will be helpful for our young people to be able to form that very good sense of civic duties and a sense of history and also a sense of politics. No? So please join us in Proyecto Filipino. Yeah, marami pong salamat. Have a good day ahead. Let's continue to pray for our country, for the electoral process, and let's pray for the new leaders who will start their service by the end of June. So again, have a good day. Thank you.
Mga kababayan, ang biyaya ng muling pagkabuhay ni Jesus ay mapasa inyo. Dahil sa inyong pakikisa sa ating panawagan na tulong, patuloy tayong nakapagpapadala ng pagkain, nagbibigay ng tulong pangkabuhayan, at nagpapatayo ng mga bahay. Subalit marami pa rin ang nangangailangan ng ating pang-alay kapwa. Hanggang Mayo 31, tayo po ay magkawanggawa para sa mga pamilyang apektado ng bagyo at ng iba pang sakuna. Maraming salamat muli at Happy Easter!